the class. I'm gonna start recording this class. Please pay attention to the screen. Stop chatting, Monica. Stop chatting. Okay, now I just want you to know, guys, that here in your platform you have everything already. What you are supposed to do over here. Let me show you. Okay. Okay. You are H. Let me second H. This one. This is yours. Cuevas is here. Here it is. Let me open it. Let me go to the science section. Here it is. Now I just want to show you that you have already what you are supposed to do. Here's week number two. Over here, watch this video. And then at the end, it says, as well, students should complete the vocabulary. I don't know if you have completed already, but you have to complete the vocabulary already, and this is the document, the PDF document, okay? I don't know if you have a book or you have a document, okay? This is a document where I got all the information, and over here is the vocabulary also. And also over here is the assessment information, okay? So, need to complete, this is vocabulary number one. Remember, we're starting the second trimester, so you have to fold a page in order to separate first trimester and second trimester, so to fold one page, write second trimester or term. And then the title of this topic is Introduction to Economic Systems. Okay, underline this on your in your notebook, and then under this title you have to write the vocabulary number one, that is on page 38. And then after you finish the vocabulary, then you have to write the assessment. You have to answer the assessment. These are the questions that you need to answer. Question 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Okay, so try working. Anyway, the class today is gonna be brief. The class is gonna be brief, and then I'm gonna give you the rest of the class. I'm gonna give you time for you to work on these two activities, the vocabulary and the assessments. That is on page 31, okay? Here is the documents, the PDF, in case you don't have the book. And this is the PowerPoint that we're going to use for this class, okay? Let's begin the class then, guys. Everybody pay attention. Now, this is the PowerPoint that is the same thing is in the platform already, okay? Now, let's begin. Good morning, Mr. Christian. How you doing? Okay, now today's class is Introduction to the Economic System. We watched already last week like four types of economic system. The traditional, the command, the free market, and the mixed market. I rather mention the mixed market, because a free market, I don't really believe that exists, because always the government is involved in a certain way in any decision in this economic system, okay? So let's begin then. These are the objectives of this section. Identify the three main type of economic system. Understand how a traditional economic operates, including its advantage and disadvantage, and analyze how modern forces are changing traditional economies. Now, these are the vocabulary words that you need to complete in your vocabulary number one. Let's begin then. Type of economic system. An economic system is the way a society uses its scarce resources. Remember, los recursos son escasos. Scarce resources to satisfy its people's unlimited wants. Remember, the resources are limited, but the wants, lo que el ser humano siempre quiere es ilimitado. We always want more and more. Okay? Now, there are three basic types of economic systems. The traditional, the command, the free market, and they don't mention them, and the last one, the market economies. Okay? Now, over here, there's a picture that shows you an Eskimo, that is an example of traditional economic. Is the Inuit, that's why they call it, this kind of people over there in North Canada, Alaska, are among the few communities that have a traditional economy. So let's begin. A traditional economy is an economic system in which families, clans, or tribe make economic decisions based on customs and beliefs that have been handed down from generation to generation. So the same thing happened over there in the area of Cherokee, Los Nove Bugle, or in the area of Guaymi, or in the area of Los Cunas. They have this kind of tradition from generation to generation. And if you go to the Amazon area also, you will find some tribes that they practice this traditional economy. Or if you had to Africa, to a specific area in the middle of Africa, there are some tribes that practice this kind of traditional economy, okay? The one and only goal of this society is survival. Sobrevivir. Esa es la única meta de este tipo de sociedad, sobrevivir. Everyone has a set of roles in this task. Todo el mundo tiene una actividad que hacer en este tipo de sociedad. Men often are hunters. Los hombres son los cazadores que van a buscar la comida. Las mujeres tend to crop, se dedican a lo que es la agricultura, cultivarla y a qué, a raise children, a encargarse de los peladitos en la casa, ¿ya? Now, los pelados, los jóvenes, the youngest help with everyday chores while learning the skills they will need for their adult roles. Encargan de sus quehaceres en casa. Todos tienen sus cosas que hacer en casa, que si limpiar, que si barrer, que si arreglar, que si fregar. Cada uno tiene una actividad que hacer, que si lavar ropa, qué sé yo. Y a la vez aprenden las habilidades que los adultos, ellos eventualmente con el tiempo van a convertirse en los líderes de su comunidad. Over here, there's a set of advantage and disadvantage of this type of traditional economy. Now, one of the advantages, there is a little to not uncertainty. O sea, hay poco de dudas. Todo el mundo sabe lo que tiene que hacer. O sea, nadie dice, ay, entonces, ¿qué vamos a hacer ahora? No, todo el mundo tiene un role to complete in this type of system, okay? Now, the second one is everyone knows what roles to play. Todo el mundo sabe lo que tiene que hacer. And life is generally stable, predictable, and continuous. La vida es monótona. No monótona, simplemente que ya todo el mundo sabe lo que tiene que hacer y sabe lo que va a suceder, okay? So, everything is under control. Now, the disadvantages of a traditional economy tend to discourage new ideas, a new way of doing things. Esto, si de repente uno dice, oye, pero ¿por qué no mejor hacemos esto de esta manera? Yo creo que va a ser mejor. Como ellos están acostumbrados a hacer las cosas de su manera, ellos dicen, ¿sabe una cosa? No, mejor nos vamos a mantenerlo siempre como está. O sea que no hay un grado de avance, no hay un progreso, ¿ok? Ese es el segundo de las desventajas. Dice, the lack of progress. Falta de progreso, o sea que no hay progreso. Todo se mantiene en su estado normal como está, como siempre. Low standard of living. Okay, simplemente trabajamos para vivir y vivimos para trabajar. That's it. Lastimosamente, así es el traditional economy. Y así fueron a sus inicios, en los inicios de la existencia del mundo. Así mismo era, ¿ya? Mariano Campo, ya apareció todo el mundo, listo. Now let's move on. Now let's go to the second economy system, that is the command economy system. Esa es la que se da en la Unión Soviética, la que se da en Cuba, la que se da lastimosamente ahora en Venezuela o en Nicaragua, que el gobierno es el que se encarga de definir qué es lo que se va a producir, cómo se va a producir y hacia quién se va a producir. Okay, las preguntas de la economía. Okay, now, command economy. The second type of economic system is a command economy. The government decides what goods or services will be produced. That's one question. The second question, how they will be produced? That's the second question. And how they will be distributed? The third question. Okay. In command economies, government officials consider the resource and need of country and allocate those resources according to their judgment. O sea que si de repente sabemos que en Chiriquí decimos que esa es la granja del país. O sea, todos los que van a estar ahí se van a dedicar solamente a la producción de ganado o la producción de agrícola, y solamente a eso se van a dedicar. Eso según el gobierno. Entonces, de repente se decimos en el norte de Coclé es un área minera, que okay, toda esa gente se va a encargar de lo que es la minería. O sea, el gobierno le dice, de acuerdo a los recursos que uno tiene, asimismo cada comunidad se va a dedicar a hacer lo que tiene que hacer en su área. The wants, los deseos of individual consumers are rarely considered. Rara vez es considerada los deseos del consumidor. Rara vez. A veces se considera, se toma en consideración. Okay? Now, this example of North Korea and Cuba are current examples of command economies. Before the collapse of communism in Europe, countries such as the Soviet Union, la USSR, la Unión de Repúblicas Soviéticas Socialistas, la USSR, Poland and East Germany. Alemania estaba dividido en dos Alemanes, Alemania Este o Alemania Oriental y Alemania Occidental. La Alemania Occidental era la comunista y la Alemania Oriental era la democrática. ¿Okay? Hasta en los años 80, donde se tumbó la famosa... había una pared entre las dos, se tumbó la barrera entre los dos países y se convirtieron en una sola Alemania. ¿Okay? Let's continue over here. There's a list of advantages and disadvantages of the command economy. Now, advantage economy can change directions drastically in a relative short time. Why? Because they are the ones who decide what to do and how to do it and what activity to do. So they don't need to ask to the people or to the consumers or to the private sector. So they are the only ones who decide what to do, okay? And what is best for the country or for the economic system, okay? Now the second one, social programs are available to almost everyone. Los programas sociales, hay muchos programas sociales, eso es lo único positivo. Que si de repente tienes que operarte o que vamos al hospital y te operas, no te cobran ni un centavo. ¿Por qué? Porque se encarga, son los programas sociales que tiene el Estado. De repente, la educación también se encarga del Estado. Education, the government, is the one who take care of your education and your health and also what you're gonna eat, okay? So everything is under control sometimes. Eso es lo ideal, sin embargo, eso a veces no sucede así, okay? Now, disadvantages, not designed to meet wants. En la economía esta no está diseñado para satisfacer las necesidades de los consumidores, okay? The ones, los deseos y las necesidades del consumidor. Decide not to meet wants on some needs of the people. Son algunas necesidades. Not incentive to work hard. O sea, no se le incentiva al que trabaja, al que da esa milla extra. No se le incentiva. Simplemente tú trabajas eso y se te va a pagar eso y punto. Si tú quieres trabajar de más, allá tú. Ese es tu problema. Requires large decision-making bureaucracy. O sea, que hay mucha burocracia. ¿Qué es burocracia? Que el Estado está lleno de personas que no tienen una actividad que hacer simplemente. Por ejemplo, si yo quiero hacer un trámite en el Estado, yo agarro este papelito y se lo digo a esta señora. Esta señora simplemente lo mira y se lo pasa a otra señora. Después esta señora simplemente le pone un sellito y después con el sello se lo pasa a otra persona para que le forme una firma. Y así se va. O sea, el Estado está lleno de personas que en realidad... Esa actividad la puede hacer solamente una persona. Eso es lo que se llama burocracia. Llenar el Estado con muchos procedimientos, muchas cosas innecesarias. Eso es la burocracia. Muy bien. Vamos a parar aquí y mañana continuamos con Market Economy, que es la última de los tres sistemas. Lo que sí he traído aquí es un video en el cual habla sobre estos mismos, el último específico, que nos va a ayudar a ver de otra manera y a darle forma a what we just studied regarding the command systems over here. Let's watch this video that talks about this command system. I give you, and they give, this guy gives you more details about these Command economy.
Channel. Today we're going to be talking about a command economy. Now make sure to check out my other videos on the different types of economies, which will be on traditional, a mixed economy, a market economy, and there'll also be some on communism and capitalism and socialism. Now enough of the different other economies, we're talking about command today. So let's figure out what a command economy is and how it answers the three basic economic questions. Now, while watching the video, make sure to take out your guided notes. You can find them in the description below. I've created these notes to go along with the video to make sure that you understand all the important information. And when it comes to your test or quiz, you can just refer back to your notes instead of watching the video again. A command economy is when we have a central authority that is going to answer all the economic questions. The government is normally what it takes the shape of. And this government will answer the what, the how, and for whom. They are in charge of everything. Individual businesses and individuals in the society have very little say of what's going on. Today, North Korea is probably the closest thing to a current day command, a true command economy. Now, communism will also fall partially under here, and we'll get to that another time when we get into capitalism, communism, and socialism. If you need to figure that out, check out those videos. But we're gonna get into now what are some of the advantages to a command economy, and what are some of the disadvantages? Now, like I just said, command economies answer the three basic economic questions with a central authority, normally taking the shape of the government. If you need more information on the economic questions, check out the video that I have on my channel. You can click the link on the top right now. But a command economy does have a bunch of advantages. It might not seem like it because you're being told what to do, but a command economy can actually change directions pretty fast. An example of it is the Soviet Union. They were able to go from a rural agricultural society to a leading industrial one in a relatively short period of time. Now, they did some things that are questionable, and we don't need to get into that right now, but as an economy goes, they moved pretty fast. Now, other advantages, too, is you don't have to worry about what you're going to do. You're kind of told. And there's a lot of public services that are offered for people at very little cost or to no cost. Now, there's a lot of disadvantages to this type of an economy, though. Now, one of the big ones is it stifles innovation and creativity. I mean, if you are getting told what to do at all times, why are you going to care? We start to see people lose incentives. People get pushed out of society. And while it can handle some bigger things and change pretty fast, it does an awful job at meeting the wants and needs of the individuals living in that country or society, wherever we're talking about, and it can't deal with the day-to-day issues. It has a very hard time grappling with those. And it also requires a huge bureaucracy that has to dictate and tell everyone what to do. And so it's very slow, especially again when it comes to these minor details. So there is some advantages to a command economy, but there's also a lot of disadvantages. And it's important to note both of them. We've seen societies throughout history that have used a command economy, and some are still using it today. And those are the main things that you need to know about a command economy. Make sure you understand how it answers the three basic economic questions, what are some of the advantages and disadvantages to it, and how the government works in this economy.
That's it, guys. So remember, guys, over here in your platform you have already, you need to complete the vocabulary on page 38 and also answer these questions, your assessment. So please, I'm gonna give you this extra minutes. Right now is 9:39, so you have like 6 minutes. So please focus on these activities, please. Complete the vocabulary and work on the assessment, okay? Do we have any questions? Questions? No questions? Okie dokie. Now let's start working on the vocabulary and assessment and see you tomorrow, okay, guys? Bye-bye, take care. See ya.